It's amazing how fast we get to April 15th, 2019. Here we are, and this is Connor McIver, longest running real estate podcast radio show for Santa Clarita Real Estate, and I'm absolutely astounded, excited, and you know, really just really excited, really happy to bring you the latest Santa Clarita Real Estate update. Let's go to scvnest.com. We'll pull all the necessary data and information. Also, this past week, we did write quite a few articles, one with Santa Clarita Homes, answering those top 8 inquiries that people want to know about with regard to that particular search provided by Google, so you can see that. If you go to scvnest.com/blog, B-L-O-G. Now, as this loads up here, we're going to give you the most recent real estate information concerning Santa Clarita Valley, talking about the market leveling out somewhat, and we're seeing it leveling out between being a buyer's market and a seller's market. So this is occurring as we speak. We did have our typical winter slowdown, and we saw that transition into more of a seller's market than a little bit of a buyer's market. So it is bouncing back and forth like a pretty non-dramatic tennis match. As we get into the summer months, though, I think we're going to be also watching as real estate inventory does continue to climb, and the question of the day at that time is going to be, is that additional inventory going to be enough to take the market from where it is currently in a pretty much evenly matched buyers and sellers market to flip that needle into a full seller's market or full buyer's market? We'll have to wait until that time, and we'll have to watch those indicators on the way. Now, if we talk about closings in the last 90 days here for all of Southern California, 10,035. That's all the listings that have sold. Santa Clarita rentals and leases, you can see those at scvns.com at 37. Real estate and escrow under contract and pending. These are properties that are currently in the process of escrow. Whether they're still showing active online under contract or pending under contract online, that's 6,746. All listings in Southern California, 15,394. That's total. Back locally here in Santa Clarita Valley, we're sitting in the market at 614. You track that back maybe a week and a half, we're about 550, so that inventory is starting to build. We don't know yet if it's going to be enough to stick around, because we've been, like I've mentioned earlier on a YouTube video that we did, our absorption rate is really keeping toe-to-toe with the levels of inventory that are entering the market for sale. On our blog, just to bring that to your attention, a couple of good points that were brought up here this last week by a couple of clients. And again, we stress this to our clients, and if you're working with another real estate agent out there, you should at least know what's going on with it. So if you're out there, let's say you're working with an agent, or let's say you haven't really chosen an agent, but you happen to be out there on a weekend, you say, you know what, there are all these people, they're spinning signs, they're advertising open houses on corners. Maybe if you're in Santa Clarita, White's turns into Plum Canyon, and there you're gonna see a lot. You got your Toll Brothers out there, you got these other developers up there, Skyview or Sky, whatever it is up there. You have these new housing, and when you go, the first thing they're gonna do, they're gonna confront you, they're gonna want you to give up who you are. They're gonna wanna get your name from you, your real name and a real email address. And they're gonna tell you, you know, and innocently enough, right? They're gonna tell you, they're gonna say, listen, you know, give us your name, we'll put you on an interest list. We'll be able to keep you updated as far as what's going on in the community. Maybe in the future we'll be giving away one free house, you know, whatever their hook is. They'll try to get you to give it up. What you do, what you've just done by giving up your name and email address, is you've basically given up your right to have your own agent negotiate for you, have your own agent represent you. And having your own agent represent you at new housing doesn't cost you anything. You can come into my office, I take you into all the new housing centers, the one that meets your criteria. Maybe you don't mind a little bit of Mellow Ruse, maybe you can't stand it, so I'll take you to according the new homes that actually fit those bills. Maybe you want a larger backyard, maybe you want to pay for a premium view lot, whatever it means, whatever you want to do, so we take you into those. When that happens, then the new housing representative allows me to register you, I put you down, and then I become your real estate representative. So then the questions start. I want to know several things, like 12 points. I have them all written out from the new home builder's representative. And I want to know in front of you. I want to know how many phases that they're going to be total. I want to know if there's going to be any additional phases added, what the chances are. I want to know when the price reductions come. I want to know what kind of inventory they're going to be carrying. I want to know if there's a change in the HOA, if it's going to actually increase it build out, if it's going to stay the same or lessen. I want to know about the Melrose tax. When's that over? What does it pay? I want to know all these items for my clients, and then after that, I want to find out how negotiable the price is. A lot of people that go into new housing are looking at it from the vantage point that if it says this on the sheet that they want, you know, $789,000 for residence two, and it's located here on this particular lot with these amenities, they want that $789,000 all day long. That's actually not the case. So then in front of my clients, I want to do that negotiation and find out what extra incentives can I get. Can we offer $749,000, $739,000? How long has that listing been sitting there? How long has that lot been available for sale? Do they have anything that might look like it's going to fall out? See, at new housing, and again, this is so important to have an expert with you. At new housing, there are kind of that insider knowledge, right? So you have these people that are representing the builder. I'm pretty close with a lot of them. So then I can find out kind of what's going on behind the scenes. They might have lot 2342, which is the model that you want. It's a residence four. It's got all the upgrades. It was in process, but maybe the buyer is not performing. Maybe the buyer has gotten cold feet. Maybe the buyer doesn't want to proceed. So then Connor McIver, knowing that, would be contacted by the new home rep, and the new home rep would say, hey, you know, I know you're representing Julie and Billy over here at the new house you signed and registered. Hey, we have one just like that that they might be able to walk into and get discounts on upgrades. And then I can also throw our hat in the ring that we want additional discounts to closing costs and so on. Because if that home doesn't sell and it sits for a while, that's not good for the shareholders, for the new builders corporation, right? So they have to get rid of it. But being on the inside track is important. That's why when you go into new housing, if you sign and you put down your name, even on a cocktail napkin, you've basically given up your right to have your own real estate representative. Open houses are a little bit different. When you go into open houses, those agents are going to say that their seller wants your information so that they can keep track of the people that came in and out of the open house. There's really nothing legally they can do to get you to give up your information, but just knowing if you put your name down, then you're probably going to be hit up by this agent sometime in the future. Even if you tell them, hey, you know, listen, I'm working with Connor McIver. The agents are notorious for not really caring, and they will proceed and contact you and maybe put you on their mailing list, and maybe then just continue to harass you until you finally tell them, listen, I'm gonna spam you if you don't go away. These are things out there that people watch out for. So I did do a little bit of writing with regard to that. And the title of that blog post is Giving Up Your Personal Info Can Be Like Shooting Yourself in the Foot. A lot of good information here. We did do an update from Paris, France, so you can see that. It was actually on the fifth floor of our hotel on the balcony, so you can see I was sitting out there with my GoPro camera. Not a bad shot. The Louvre is right behind me, kind of over my shoulder, so you can check that out. It was a good time. Food didn't impress me. Not that I was looking for the food to impress me, but I guess I was. You know, what did impress me were the pastries and the sweets. Yeah, the French know how to do that. And everybody was good. If you started any conversation with hello, didn't end well, but if you started a conversation with bonjour, and then if you didn't even go any further attempting to speak French, you were still golden. They just like it when you at least make that first salutation acknowledging where you are, and not that Americans have the key to every other country sort of thing. I'm Connor McIver. That's been your real estate update. Here we are. We are in the mid April 2019, I will tell you. We'll be back next Monday, if not before. Check out Santa Clarita Real Estate, and you can run that in a Google search. You'll see scvnest.com there. Also, Housing Radio is going to be the place where this particular real estate radio show is going to be uploaded. As always, we have a SoundCloud platform in place to put it out there, get the info out there. If you have any other information, need questions answered, feel free. We do have some inquiries that we get on a weekly basis, and we do our best to answer those within the radio show format that we have at housingradio.com. Connor McIver, it's been a great pleasure. Thank you so much for listening. We will talk to you very soon. Be safe. Over and out.